today I've got my BBB own make bent pot. And it's full of some Bell's Three Nuns, which I'm reviewing. This is a really nice smoke. I guess some history. This is an old blend, an old label at least. McBaron has started producing it. It's been around forever. C.S. Lewis actually smoked Bell's Three Nuns. But I think several times possibly the blend has changed, and it is my understanding at present there is no Perique in this blend, which was in the older blends. There's Perique in, for example, Cornell & Diehl's Three Friars, which is a sort of a tribute to Three Nuns. You can get that little catchy name. I like this. This is a Virginia Kentucky blend, maybe listed on Tobacco Reviews as Virginia Burley, but it's dark fired Kentucky Burley that's in here. It's a nice smoke. I like it. I'll go ahead and I guess give my conclusion. I like the smoke a lot, and the only thing that may keep me from buying it is I tend to go for best value, best bang for my buck. And so you may see that in some of my reviews. I may say, I really like this, I'd love to smoke more of it, but it's not available in bulk. So I think, you know, if I can get something for half as much that's just not quite there, but still pretty good, a lot of times I'll choose the cheaper bulk offering. I'm going to be comparing this somewhat in my review to some of the other Virginia Burley blends, Virginia Kentucky blends I've smoked. And so far, those other blends only include two very much cheaper blends. There's Neumünster Superior Round Slices is another sort of coin cut roll cake that is available in bulk for, you know, depending obviously on how much you buy, you can get it less than $3 an ounce. So that's quite attractive to me anyway. The other is very affordable, and it's Peter Stokeby's Amsterdam, which is a very thin ribbon cut tobacco. Which I believe that one is 50% Kentucky. This blend is different than those. All three of these that I'm talking about are Virginia Kentucky blends, but Three Nuns is very smooth and deep in its flavor profile. It doesn't have the brighter notes that I get from Superior Round Slices. The Virginia notes are not those kind of like bright, tangy sorts of grassy Virginia notes. You don't get those here. It's more the deeper, smoother notes. It's in some ways almost a cigar-like smoke in that sense. You do get some Virginia sweetness peeking in. I think it's cigarish in a good way. I do want to say that. For some reason, I don't get the same fullness of Kentucky flavor that I would get from Amsterdam and Superior Round Slices. That same Kentucky flavor, it's there, you can get it, but it's not either there's not as much of it, it's maybe a different type of leaf. Maybe there's some other Burley in here that's not the Kentucky Burley that does give it sort of that nuttiness and slightly cigarish notes without that dark-fired kind of... I almost think of it as a tanginess. It's almost like a smokiness, but not a Latakia campfire smokiness. It's maybe more a barbecue-type smokiness. It doesn't seem to be quite as... have as much nicotine kick as, like, Amsterdam. That's a big... it'll knock you on your hiney if you're not used to it or not watching for it. It has great moisture content, I think, to smoke right out of the tin. I really appreciate that. You know, if you are getting stuff that's, you know, you're buying however much for an ounce, and a good portion of that ounce is just extra water that you're going to want to dry out anyway, you know, maybe you're not getting as good a deal on that tobacco as it might otherwise seem. Whereas, you know, in this tin, you're getting them 1.75 ounces, but it's a lot more of that is tobacco and a lot less is water. So at least that's a good thing. So like I said, a nice, deep, all-around good smoke. That's the lower mid-range and bass notes, not as much of the high treble notes. I do not get a tendency for this to bite, which I actually do get from Superior Round Slices sometimes. So I like this. I'll need to compare it and maybe sort of revisit it. I'll certainly do that as I try some of the other McBaron offerings that are similar. Those would be the Dark Twist Roll Cake has got some Dark Fired Kentucky in there with some Virginia. And then Old Dark Fired is also a Virginia Kentucky blend. So I'll probably smoke those too, and when I do those reviews, I'll compare them to Three Nuns and kind of see if I can explain the differences. And you know, maybe you've had one of those or you've had this one and you're wanting to know if you can you'd like the other. Hopefully I can give you an idea. So look forward to seeing those reviews at some point. And thanks for this opportunity to review this blend. John Schoen, I appreciate it. Cheers, guys.